good to be back in the house of the Lord this morning, and thankful that we have the opportunity to read God's Word.
Amen.
If you would turn your books to your Bibles to the book Romans 14. We're going to try to speak a little bit, read a little bit, and make a few comments if the Lord leads in Him that is weak. And I find that more than often I get very weak, and we need to watch over one another, and if we see one weak, well, we need to encourage. But in chapter 14, verse 1 of the book of Romans, him that is weak in the faith, now this is those, I believe, that are saved, and receive ye, but not to doubtful disputations. And this is disputations is a debating or a questioning someone about their faith or questioning them about their beliefs or whatever. But anyway, we see that we are to help those that are weak in the faith. And as we see these things, we need to remember ourselves and to encourage ourselves that what we're trying to do is what that the Lord Jesus did for us.
Amen.
And, that he seen our weakness, and that it was a weakness that no man could cure. And in this weakness here, a lot of times a word spoken in the right manner and in the right time will encourage a Christian to be more strong and give him courage. And so it says, him that is weak in the faith, receive ye, but not to doubt for dispensation. For one believeth that he may eat all things. And of course, this is going back to a lot of to the Old Testament and what that God had told the people there, some of the animals that they could eat and some of them that they couldn't eat, and one of them, you know, was the hog and or anything with a forked hoof and that didn't chew the cud, it couldn't eat. But anyway, here Paul is bringing this to us. Let it, for one believeth that he may eat all things, another who is weak eateth herbs. And of course, again, this is not altogether me, but this is the thing that a lot of people need encouraging in, and I believe a lot of this is in their beliefs in how to serve the Lord, even as they, as it says here about eating herbs and stuff of this nature and trying to condition their body. But he says here, let not him that eateth despise him that eateth not. And of course, you know, even today we have some of the Catholics and the others that they don't eat, they eat fish on Friday. They think it's wrong to, I'm assuming, to eat pork on Friday or to eat beef on Friday or whatever, but they eat fish. Well, hey, that's not no damnable heresy. But the thing of it is, it's for us, you know, to think upon this as an example of how people, what people do, and how people act, and how people eat, how people believe in different things that we do not see. And so he says here, let not him that eateth despise him that eateth not, and let not him that eateth not judge him that eateth, for God hath received him. And we see here that the word judge is used here. And of course, if we make a decision on something like that and say that it's wrong for this person to do this, then we're taking the place of God and we're judging. And here he says here, let him not judge him that eateth, for God hath received him. And again, this is a saved person. Who art thou that judgest another man's servant? To his own master he standeth or falleth. Yea, he shall be holden up, for God is able to make him stand.
Amen.
And I believe this morning what he's saying here is that God is able to show him if he's wrong or if he's doing something that is not pleasing to God. The Holy Spirit is here for a comforter. The Holy Spirit is here for one that will talk to our spirits, and he can talk to our spirits, and I know he can, and he does. And he will tell us these things. He'll show us signs. He'll show us things and warn us about what that we're doing that's displeasing to God. And even if it's eating green onions, I mean, you know, whatever it might be. And I'm just using that as an example. The Holy Spirit will show you where you're going wrong or
how
you're doing to displeasing God. And that's something we need to really keep in mind when we pray and when we address Jesus and ask him to go to the Father. We need to encourage Jesus to let him know that we need the help of the Holy Spirit. That's our director, and he directs us. And so here he says again here in verse 5, one man esteems or values one day above another. Another esteems every day alike. Let every man be fully persuaded in his own mind. And so if I say I need to go to church on Saturday because it's Saturday and Saturday is better than Sunday, I need to have some help. And if I get the notion about doing one thing and it's contrary to the Bible, I need the help. And so this is what I wanted to show you here about this. But now I want you to notice this in verse 14 of this chapter, as Paul was writing to the church and he's talking about these things and he had given all of these things. But in verse 14 he says, I know and am persuaded by the Lord Jesus that there is nothing unclean.
Amen.
Of itself. But to him that esteem anything to be unclean, to him it is unclean. And if I feel like that it's wrong for me to eat chicken, then I shouldn't eat chicken.
Right.
And it's the same way with anything that if I'm tithing a tenth of my money, my income. And the Lord through the Holy Spirit is saying, hey, you're not doing enough. Well, I'm doing a tenth. But listen, I need to find out and get the leadership of the Lord and do what he has for me to do. Because, listen, that's what I'm here for. And if he wants 10 more percent, listen, I should try to do it.
Amen.
And Paul here is talking about this unclean of itself. Anything that we eat, if we ask God's blessings on it, God has cleansed it. Because even in Peter's vision, there when he was at Joppa, you know, he said, Peter, don't you call that which God has made clean unclean. And of course, he's seen all of these four-footed beasts there, and he said, you know, I've never eaten any of that. But listen, God changed Peter's mind.
Amen.
And he went over there to Cornelius, and he told Cornelius and all of them. And here, Paul, no doubt, has heard this, read this, and he says, hey, I am persuaded. I understand that there is nothing unclean of itself, but to him that seemeth anything to be unclean, to him it is unclean. And so this morning I want you to turn with me, if you would, now to chapter 15. We want to read just a few more scriptures here. In verse 1 of chapter 15, we then that are strong ought to bear the infirmities of the weak.
Amen.
And not to please ourselves. So this morning again, when he's saying bear the infirmities, these infirmities, this word infirmity comes from people that are sick that it's not talking as much about saved people as it is weak people in the flesh, sick people. These infirmities are they're called infirmities because they go to the hospital and try to get well of these things. And this is one of the things this morning that we as God's people need to try to understand and help those that are feeble-minded, those that are broken down from disease and things like this, because it says here, we ought to bear the infirmities of the weak and not to please ourselves. In other words, if we can help them do something, then we need to do something else for our own benefit or our pleasure. Listen, we need to try to help them.
Amen.
That's what we're supposed to do, because, you know, I bring it back again. Jesus had a good home. He had a beautiful home. He had a heavenly home. But we were down here in our infirmities. We
right.
were weak. We were lost. We were undone. We were hell bound. And he gave up that. And he said, yes, Father, I'll go down there. But not only that, but I'll die for these people. And I'll take care of their infirmities. I'll do something that will help them in their infirmities and even in their salvation. So here he says in verse 2, let every one of us please his neighbor for his good to edification or instruction. Now, again here, it's our responsibility to help our neighbors. And God says, love your neighbor as yourself. But here he says here, let everyone please his neighbor for his good to edification or to build up or to instruct or enlighten. That's what this edification means. In other words, if we can enlighten him in the scriptures, if we can encourage him in anything, or if we can do anything because he is sick, he's in bed or something like that, that's our purpose. That's one of our purposes. And that is pleasing to God because he told us to do it. And so he said here, for even Christ pleased not himself, but as it is written, the reproach of them that reproach thee fell on me. And so the reproach of men here that were sinners, all of that sin and all of that fell on Jesus Christ.
Right.
And he carried that sin to the cross, and he carried it only into he carried it to the cross, and then he carried the blood atonement to heaven to take care of that sin that was on him. And listen, he took care of it. And that, again, this morning is what we, as God's people, need to do in helping the people with the infirmities that they have. And that's not just to say, well, I hope you get the feeling better. Or if there's anything I can do, let me know. And you're seeing all the time that maybe they're out of food or they're sick and they need to go to the doctor or something like that. Listen, we need to take the bull by the horns.
Amen.
That's what we're supposed to do. Because one day we'll need it, because we already have needed it once when Jesus Christ came to this earth and died.
Amen.
For us. If he'd have said, well, if you need me, holler. Well, you know, that don't get the job done. And so, anyway, that's some of the things. I want you to look, if you would, to this morning at Galatians 6. Galatians 6 and verse 1. Galatians 6 and verse 1. It says, brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of meekness. And, you know, that is a great word.
Mm-hmm.
That is a great word, because here, I know it. I've seen it. I know what will happen. People that are ready to fly away, and the devil really pats him on the back and says, hey, you're the best thing since peanut butter. And he says, hey, you need to go over and talk to somebody about this. Well, they come go over there all boasted up and all and saying and pointing their finger. And people, I know what I'm talking about, because I've been on visitations. I've been on visitations, and this thing happened. And the first thing they do is they want to cram something down that man's throat or that woman's throat. And that just turns it off like a light bulb. Mm-hmm. And they will not accept it. And so what we need to do, if we have an opportunity to to encourage anybody is, first of all, Lord, help me to do it through meekness.
Amen.
Help me to do it in a way that would be pleasing to you, because listen, Jesus Christ did not come to this earth and point his finger at us and say, hey, you know, if it wasn't for me, you're all going to go to hell and you shouldn't have done this. Listen, he come at meek as a lamb. And here he says here in verse 1, brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted.
Man.
And so this thing has got a backfire, if you would, and it's just like you shoot a shotgun and goes off and it backs up. Well, listen, it's the same way with that gun and that action. It comes back on you if you don't use it in the right way. If God leads you to do something like that and you go in the flesh and you go all boasted up and do that, listen, according to the way I understand it, he says, consider thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Bear ye one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ, the law of love. Love thy neighbor as thyself. And he says, for if a man think himself to be something when he is nothing, he deceiveth himself.
Amen.
That this morning will bring you back to this meekness.
Amen.
That will bring you right back to it, because listen, I know in myself that I'm nothing. And this old flesh likes sometimes to say, hey, boy, you got it. You know what you're doing. You this and you that. But listen, I understand the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
I understand how it works. And I know that I can't put no confidence in it. I can't pay no attention to it, because listen, it will sidetrack you in a heartbeat. It will tell you things that you want to hear, and it'll get you out of line. So here he says, but let every man prove, in verse 4, but let every man prove his own work, and then shall he have rejoicing in himself alone and not in another. And so you can rejoice in your work. You can thank the Lord in your work if you do it in a meek way, and if you go to the person with love in your heart and you try to say whatever you would, and if he spits in your face, hey, that's all right.
Right.
I mean, it's not all right for the flesh, because I know what the flesh wants to do. But the thing of it is, you did what you could do with a heart of meekness. And if he does that and rejects you, hey, that's all you can do. And so in fact, the business Jesus told him one time, he said, when you go into this town and hey, and you witness to them and all this, they don't accept you, shake the dust off your feet and leave them. And that's what you can do is if you do that, you can say, well, I've done what you asked me to do, Lord. So he says, and then shall he have rejoicing in himself alone and not in another. And so you can leave rejoicing because that you've done what God would have you to do. So for every man shall bear his own burdens. Let him that is taught in the word communicate unto him that teacheth in all good things. So he says here, let him that is taught in the word communicate, talk together unto him that teacheth in all good things. In other words, good communication between brethren, and it's good, because the thing of it is, the Holy Spirit might show your pastor or your friend, your brother, in something that he hasn't showed you.
Right.
And he can deliver that to you. And that's what he says here. Let every man that is taught in the word communicate unto him that teacheth in all good things. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap.
Amen.
So I think this morning that is a very good warning to us that this meekness that and the things that we try to do to encourage someone, we need to do it in meekness, because again he says, be not deceived, and you're not going to get by with anything. God is not mocked. So if you sow something, if you speak something in a haughty, ungodly nature, and you get this person that you're talking to in worse shape than he was, and you get him offended, and then you can't touch him, then listen, he says God is not mocked. So what you have sown, you're going to reap it. And if you reap it, why, how are you going to reap it? You're going to be in the same shape he is, and someone's going to have to come to you. And so, listen, that's how the thing goes. So, again, remember to love thy neighbor as thyself, and to when you talk to someone, do it with a heart of meekness, and I think you'll find that it will be a whole lot better, because so many people, you know, they want to bring in everything in this world for salvation. Circumcision, going to church, baptism, and all of these things, and people we know what that's all about.
Right.
Amen. But the thing of it is, we still only have a heart of love in us and try to understand what they're going through. So here, let's get a little bit more and we'll close. He says in verse 8 of chapter 6 here, it says, for he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting.
Amen.
And let us not be weary in well-doing. Don't throw up your hands when you're just about to get through and say, I give up. Because listen, it might be just right over the hill, right over the corner, that you're going to see a soul saved. You're going to help encourage someone to seek the Lord. So he says, let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. As we have therefore opportunities, let us do good unto all men, especially unto them who are of the household of faith. And of course Paul goes on to tell them about the letter he wrote. But anyway, this is what I feel like that the Lord would have us to here this morning, and who knows, today may be the day that you'll get to be a witness, and that you'll get to talk to someone and tell someone about the Lord. And maybe these words that we've read here will be a help to you, and you'll see some results. So I thank you so much for listening, and pray for us as we try to bring this Sunday school lesson, as we try to read God's word, and we ask your prayers for us as we try to study. Thank you so much.